Jiva. Let's start it. Here in the chapter number 10. This is a beautiful poem about the monkey. Okay? So, my dear students, let's start it. Standard 4, subject English. Chapter number 10. The name of the chapter number 10 is The Big Baboon. What is the name of the chapter? The Big Baboon. So, this poem is in your textbook, page number 64. Okay? 64. So, now let's start it. So, here if you see the title of the poem, The Big Baboon. So, in your mind, the question is created in your mind. Okay, what is the question? What is the meaning of baboon? Okay, what is the meaning of baboon? So, baboon. Baboon is the name of the monkey. Okay, baboon is the name of the monkey. A large monkey with a long hair. Okay, a large monkey with a long hair and also a long face. It's called baboon. Okay, once again. What is the spelling of baboon? B-A-B-O-O-N. Baboon. Baboon means a large monkey with a long face. So this poem is about the monkey. This monkey is found upon the Canada, Columbia, British Columbia in Canada. Okay, this monkey found upon the British Columbia in Canada. And also the shocking thing about the monkey is the monkey is wearing nothing. Okay, the monkey is wearing nothing. This is the shocking thing about the monkey. And also the poet wants to wants to the monkey wear a dress, okay, well dress. So the monkey was a respectably, okay, and looking like a gentleman. So the poet wants to the poem. The monkey wear a good dress. Okay, so this is very easy poem and interesting poem also, because the poem is about the monkey. So my dear students, let's start it. Okay, let's start it. The big baboon is found upon the plains of Caribou. He goes about with nothing on, a shocking things to do. But if he dresses respectably and let his whiskers grow, how like this big baboon could be to Mr. So and So. Okay? And this beautiful poem is written by Hilary Belloc. Okay? What is the name of the poet? Hilary Belloc. Okay? So what is the spelling of the name of the poet? H-I-L-A-R-E Hilary Belloc. B-E-L-L-O-C Belloc. Hilary Belloc. Okay, this poem is written by Hilary Belloc. Hilary Belloc written this beautiful, very goodly. Okay, very good. Okay, let's start it. Here in the first line, the big baboon. Firstly, I explain the words of big baboon, and I explain the meaning of the big baboon. Big means very large, and baboon means a large monkey with a long face. Okay, large monkey with a long face. So, a big baboon is found upon the plains. Plains means, what is the meaning of plains? So, the plains means a large area. Okay, plains means a large area. And Caribou. Caribou is also the name of the place. Okay, Calico is the place of British Columbia in Canada. Okay, Calico is the place of the British Columbia in Canada. So this big baboon is found upon the plains of the Calico. It means the big baboon, the large monkey with a long face, is found upon a large area of the British Columbia in Canada. He goes about with nothing on, a shocking thing to do. Here means these two lines mention about the monkeys. This monkey wearing nothing on. Okay, this monkey wearing nothing on, and this is very shocking, things about the monkey. But if he dressed respectably means in a way people find acceptable and good things. Okay, what is the meaning of respectably? Way, and in this way people find acceptable and good thing. It's called respected. So here he means the poet. The poet wants to the monkey wear a good dress. Okay, respectably. And let his whiskers grow. Whiskers means a long strips hair on the animal. Okay, whiskers. Whiskers also a new word for you. W-H-I-S-K-E-R-S. Whiskers. Whiskers means a long strips hair in the animal's body. It's called whiskers. So here let his whiskers grow. How like the big baboon would be to Mr. So and So. Mr. M-I-S-T-E-R. Mr. So and So means looking like a gentleman. So, my dear friends, in the poem, the monkey, the large monkey with a long face found in a place of British Columbia in Canada. And this monkey wearing nothing. But in the poem, the poet wants to the monkey wear a good dress because he wants to monkey looking like a gentleman. So he must be prefer the monkey so wear a good dress. Okay, this is the poem. Here your poem is over. So now let's start the glossary of the poem. Okay, let's start it. So let's start it. Glossary. First word is baboon. B A B double O N. Once again, B A B double O N. Baboon. Baboon means a large monkey with a long face. Okay? Baboon means a large monkey with a long face. It's called baboon. Okay? Baboon means a large monkey with a long face. Plains. P-L-A. What is the spelling of plains? P-L-A-I-N-S. Plains means a large area or a flat land. Okay? What is the meaning of plains? A large area or flat land. Caribou. C-A-R-I-B-O-O. Caribou. Okay? C-A-R-I-B-O-O. Caribou means a place in British Columbia in Canada. Caribou means a place in British Columbia in Canada. Respectively, R done that. So my dear students, this is the glossary of the poem. So let's revise once again the glossary. Let's revise it. Babun, B-A-B-O-O-N, babun. Babun means a large monkey with a long face. A large monkey with a long face. Plains, P-L-A-I-N-S. Plains means a large area or flat land. A large area or flat land. Caribou, C-A-R-I-B-O-O. Caribou means a place in British Columbia in Canada. Respectively, R-E-S-P-E-C-T-A-B-L-Y. Respectively means in a way people find acceptable and good. Whiskers, W-H-I-S-K-E-R-S. Whiskers, the long stiff hair on the face of an animal. Mr. So-and-so means a gentleman. Here the poem is over. Once again I explain about the poem. Pay attention here, students. Big Baboon. The Big Baboon is the story of the monkey. A large monkey with a long face. It's called Baboon. And this Baboon is wearing nothing on his body. So this is the very shocking news about the monkey. And here in the poem, the poet wants to the monkey wear a good dress. Because the poet wants the monkey looking like a gentleman. So the poet wants to monkey wearing a dress. And also this monkey is this monkey had a long stiff hair on his body. Okay, so this is the poem of the monkey. Okay, let's start with the questions. So here are some question answers about the poem. And these question answers in your textbook, page number 65. So let's start it. First question is, where does the big baboon live? Okay, what is the spelling of what is the question? Where does the big baboon live? The big baboon lives in a place of British Columbia in Canada. What is the answer? The big baboon lives in place of British Columbia in Canada. Second, what does the big baboon wear? Okay, what does the big baboon wear? So here in the question, in the poem, the big baboon wearing nothing. In the poem, the big baboon wearing nothing. What, third question, what is shocking about the big baboon? So the shocking about the big baboon is that the big baboon wearing nothing. Fourth, how can the big baboon become a gentleman? So the big baboon can become a gentleman if the big baboon wearing a dress. Why does the poet wish that the big baboon wore a respectably? So the poet wants to the big baboon like a gentleman. So the poet wish that the big baboon wore a respectable dress. Have you seen a baboon in a zoo? So yes. this question. Have you seen a baboon in the zoo?
Yes, we have seen a baboon in a zoo.
What are types of monkeys? You know,
so we know the many types of monkeys like a Kala, the Tarzan stories, and other is the Swift. Okay, this monkey is the Columbia, and also we know the other monkey is Emmy in the story of Congo. Okay, so we know the many types of monkey. Here, number 7.
Name some famous monkey characters from any stories you have read.
This question is also right in your own self. Okay, but now we explain some characters about the monkeys here. Okay, so pay attention here. If you read the stories, so the characters of the monkeys, Kala, the Tarzan stories, Swift in Colombia, Annie the Congo, then the other is Copies. Okay, Copies is the Anant Paris. And also the Curious George. Okay, this is the types of the monkeys. So dear students, now your poems and also exercise is over. So I hope you understand the glossaries, poems and question answer. So you prepare these poems and also question answers and glossary at home. Okay, be safe at your home. Thank you.